For me, one of the earliest memories I have of the Word of God was just reading all of these things that God says about us, about the world, about how things should be, and wondering, why is my life so far away from that reality? Why is the world around me so far away from the reality that God has envisioned for us? As I began to understand more about the reality of sin and brokenness and what it has done to our hearts and our nature and humanity as a whole, I could only look to God more and more for answers that I couldn't find anywhere else. And when Jesus prays, "Let it be on earth just as it is in heaven," I understood that this is not just the prayer of an idealist wanting everything to be perfect on earth, but this is the prayer of Christ who gave his own life for this to be made possible. He wasn't just telling us to bring heaven down to earth. He wasn't just telling us that our lives should reflect, what heaven looks like, but he literally paid the whole price, the ultimate price, the full price of what was needed for us to have heaven on earth in our day-to-day lives, in our regular mundane lives. Now, when we look into what that looks like, there's so much we can gain and glean from the Word of God on how God wants us to live, on how he wants us to be in the world. The Bible says that we are the light of the world. God says that let your good deeds shine before all men so that they can see that and give glory to your Father in heaven. So what does it really look like for heaven to come to earth? One of the things that completely turned my life around was understanding that I cannot gain anything in this kingdom through my own righteousness. I've always been a great student in school. Yes, there have been years where I didn't do well, but I've always been first rank student and all of that. So I understood merit. I understood, achieving great things. But I realized that we are so, so empty without God. We are so broken without him that we cannot achieve anything in the kingdom of God except what God has already given us, what Christ has already paid for us to have. And that completely changed my identity and the way I started to live as a Christian. When I realized that my righteousness did not come from within me or from my efforts or my works, and when I began to receive what Jesus has done, what Jesus has brought down to earth for us, that's when my life really, really began to change. My heart began to change. I began to desire the things that God desires. I began to forgive a lot more easily. I began to, accept his love, accept his forgiveness. And I stopped living in guilt and shame, though it was a journey. And just like our lives have reflected Christ over the years. It was not an instant change. At least for me, it was not an instant change. It was a very slow day-by-day process of reading the Word of God, understanding Christ's nature, understanding his love, knowing Jesus personally, and eventually I began to see his power, his glory, his truth. I began to see these things that were once just concepts, but now they were realities in my life. And I really believe that heaven on earth is not an idealistic saying. It's not something that Jesus prayed because, he just had a very great imagination, but he literally paid the price for us to walk in heaven's reality on earth. And we don't have to wait till the transfiguration of our bodies or till we actually pass away from this world to live lives that God died for us to live. And every time I am tempted to settle for anything less, I keep remembering this, that Jesus died for me to have heaven right now, to have his presence right now. And what does that mean? It does not mean the absence of pain. It does not mean the absence of sickness. It does not mean the absence of difficulties. But it does mean the presence of God, the presence of His healing, the presence of His power working in and through us. And that is why we have faith to look at someone sick and say, in the name of Jesus, you have been healed. That is why we have the power to look at someone so broken and say, God's grace is sufficient for you. You know, in your weakness, God's strength is made perfect. And Jesus is the reason we have courage to not see the things around us and give up, but know that there is a hope living inside of us, Christ in us, the hope of glory, which is not just reserved for one day, but reserved for right now. And I don't know about you, when I hear the things that are happening around us, when I read the news and get to know the extent of pain that is around us, my only hope is that we are the hands and feet of Jesus. We are His bride. We are the light and salt of this earth, placed very, very intentionally by God to not just live a comfortable life, to not just live a saved life and wait to get to heaven, but to be His hands and feet, to be His image on earth and reflect heaven on earth in everything that we do, whether it is in our speech, whether it is in our songs, whether it is in our life, our work, our parenting, and in every way that we live to reflect Jesus. I'm going to share this verse from Galatians chapter 4. In verse 6, it says, "Because you are His sons, God sent the Spirit of His Son into our hearts, the Spirit who calls out, Abba, Father. So you are no longer a slave, but God's child. And since you are His child, God has also made you an heir." Knowing that God has given us the fullness of His inheritance, when we become mature sons and daughters of God, when we start to walk in authority, walk in the fruit of His Spirit, walk in true character and purity, we get to see all these different ways in which heaven becomes real on earth. It may not always look glorious, but it looks like forgiveness. It looks like mercy. It looks like humility. It looks like loving even when it is difficult. It looks like being patient even when it is difficult. And these are the ways in which heaven is coming to earth, one kind word at a time, one gracious smile at a time. And when you start to believe that you have that power, you have the ability to carry God's culture, His character, His intentions for this world, that's when you begin to live like heaven is coming to earth. And I just pray that as we continue living our lives, that our prayer would be the same as Jesus' prayer when He said, "God, let your kingdom come and your will be done on earth just as it is in heaven."